This is the MLB pregame show, and I'm Matt Vasgersian. And as we draw nearer to the first pitch of Game 1 in the series, we'll give you the latest installment of our Topps Player Spotlight. Gerald Hayden comes into this one with hits in each of his last 10 games. What do you think is contributing to his recent success, and what do you think about his chances of extending his streak in this one?
Yeah, Matty, consistent hitting mechanics, a great eye, feel for the barrel right there, Matty. I actually think it's going to continue. This guy looks so calm in the box, I don't see that he doesn't get a knock today.
Okay, we're looking forward to this one. Lineups and first pitch on the show coming up next. Now, nighttime baseball from Northern California's Bay Area in Oracle Park. Got an NL Western Division showdown tonight between the San Diego Padres and the San Francisco Giants. Alongside Dan Plesac and Mark DeRosa, and Danny, as pitching matchups go, it doesn't get much better than what we've got here for this one.
Well, Matt, these are two of the best in the business, two guys that throw a lot of strikes, and if their game is on, we should have a very low-scoring ball game with these two elite starting pitchers.
Giants baseball is next. So now to the plate, Gerald Hayden, as the switch hitter will bat right-handed here.
Even though he's batting right-handed in this particular bat, this guy swings it from both sides of the plate. Numbers pretty much the same across the board. A terrific hitter, right-handed in this.
There's a swing and a drive, and everybody's just going to sit back and watch that one fly. A no-doubt home run. So a two-run shot to left center, home run number 5 on the year, as the Padres have taken a 2-0 lead.
Well, D-Row, you know, they say records are made to be broken. And what a monster year this guy's had.
Yeah, there it is, Dan. Most RBIs in one season. I can't begin to tell you.
Ready to take his hacks now again. Gerald Hayden blasted a two-run homer in his last at-bat.
And that's been the entire offense so far in this one. They've been shut down other than that.
First pitch on the way. Hit pretty well out toward right center field. Long run for the center fielder, but he's not going to get there, and he's headed for extra bases again. And he's in safely to third, as a run will score on the play as well.
Boy, this guy's having a great game here so far, D-Row. Home run earlier in the night, and that base hit right there drives in his third run batted in of this game.
Yeah, you drive to the park every day hoping your rhythm and timing is on point with that pitcher's windup. And that's exactly been the case today. Now he not only mixed in that big bomb, but now he's got three ribbies to boot.
Junior at third with nobody out. Liner in there for a base hit, and that'll bring home another as they open it up to a 4-0 advantage now.
Yeah, and when a pitching coach goes to the mound this early, he's probably just looking to reset the pitcher's mindset, get him to forget about the negative, and give him something positive to focus on. We'll see if he responds.
So next to bat will be Gerald Hayden. He's got a homer and a triple to this point in the game.
Let's go right here, man. Let's do it.
First pitch of the AB now. Five runs, 8 hits. No errors in the ballgame for the Padres. Ground ball sent back up the middle, and that's through into center field. Base hit. The runner from second crosses the plate. It's a 6-0 ball game.
Boy, talking about having a game, D-Row, with that knock right there, his 4th RBI of this game.
Yeah, you put your key in the ignition to drive home after this one. You got a nice smile on your face as you check out the rearview mirror. 4 ribeye steaks does not happen often.
runner at first now with batting. Two gone in the inning. And that'll bring up Fernando Tatis Jr. Now the 3-2 pitch. Swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. So it's two runs on two hits, no errors, and a runner left. On now to the bottom half of inning number four. Padres lead it 6-0. Gerald Hayden will stand in here, but before he does, let's take you back to the very first inning. This was a two-run home run right out of the gate that really got these guys off to a fast start. Here it comes. Line drive, and that's a base hit into center field. The throw into second. And a nice job to get the ball in quickly. He'll be held to a single here with nobody out.
Boy, talk about having a day, D-Bro. He gets his fourth knock of the game, but mixed in with one of those four was a round tripper. Not a bad day.
Yeah, you have five, maybe a handful of games that you can throw out four knocks throughout the course of the year. Add in a tater to go with it. He's smiling. His food's going to taste better tonight.
Runners on the move for second. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Lazar is under it. And he hauls it in for the first out of the inning. Digging in will be Gabriel Moreno. He's got a hit in three at bats to this point.
Gabriel Moreno.
Wheels and deals. Here's the first pitch. Pitch is a ball strike. The throw. Not in time. He's in there at second. Well, when a stolen base is that close, it's interesting to check it out on ShowTrack. And as the numbers come in, you'll want to focus on the top speed. Really good, and it paid off there. Next, it'll be Gabriel Moreno. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far.
Moreno.
He's ready. Here's the 0-1. Fastball right back to the mound. And he'll just flip this on to first for the second out of the inning. So here now is Ty France. No hits for him yet in the game despite his team's offensive onslaught. He's set. Here's the 3-0. And this misses here for ball four. Just the second walk he's issued here into his seventh inning of work. Stepping in once again is Michael Harris. He's 0-for-2 thus far in this one. Here it comes on 3-0. He loses him on ball four.
These guys on defense are still within striking distance, but after that walk, one swing of the bat could really blow this thing wide open.
Ozzie Albies.
There we go.
This is lined into left field, and he delivers a big base hit. And they'll extend their lead even further as the run from third is in to score.
Yeah, now they're looking at a 5-run deficit, and that doesn't bode very well for them, especially considering that they've only been able to scratch a couple of runs across the entire game. If this isn't the end, they can definitely see it from here.
So now a guy making a lot of noise in this one, Gerald Hayden. He's got his sights set on a 5-hit ball game here. And now the first pitch. And that's lifted the other way out to left. Doms is there, makes the catch, and the side is retired. Padres down at
Well, just another day at the office for these guys. That stretches their winning streak to 5, and they're playing well in all three phases of the game. Pitching, fielding, and hitting. Who knows how long this will last.
And this evening's ends at a 7-2 finish. The San Diego Padres jumped out to an early lead in the first and never looked back. Mackenzie Gore takes the